Hey everyone, let's take a moment to look a little deeper into AMP for Endpoints and how it is designed to help prevent attacks, detect new threats, and surgically respond to that 1% of malware to contain new outbreaks. We started our dashboard. Here we see an overview of the health of our enterprise. On the left, we have an organizational breakdown which acts as a heat map, showing us which groups show the highest level of compromise. The deeper the color, the deeper the compromise. Below, we have a timeline view to see when attacks began. In the center, we have our quarantine detections. These are all of the threats AMP has protected us against. Again, here we see a similar heat map view showing us which groups had the greatest number of quarantines. On the far right, we have the vulnerabilities pane, which gives us a bit of insight into the groups that have endpoints running vulnerable software. This helps us to determine which of our endpoints are potentially ripe for compromise, giving you the chance to patch before that happens. From our dashboard, we move into our inbox. This is where we can start diving deeper into those detections by analyzing the endpoint in depth. The inbox provides us with the same heat map as before and allows us to zoom into the groups to start investigating threats. Here we see a specific group that is exceptionally compromised, and we can drill deeper into it. Here, we see all of the endpoints in this group that are compromised, and expanding on the endpoint gives us all of the details around that compromise. This helps us to begin understanding this new threat. Looking at the events associated with this attack, we see the endpoint exhibited malicious behavior leading up to the compromise, what looks to be an exploit of Java. To dive further into the event and better understand the state of the endpoint, we click on it to move into device trajectory. This is a living view of all of the files as they exist on the endpoint for the past 30 days. Here we can see relationships between files and network communications, made both outbound and inbound. Device trajectory gives us the ability to pivot around a compromise, in this case, the incident where Java was exploited. Not only can we see what's happening on the endpoint after the compromise, but we can also see the state of the endpoint leading up to that compromise. This gives us the ability to find the true source and begin a precise response to this attack. Here, we see that just prior to the compromise of Java, there were outbound communications to the PwnMe exploit domain, this being the true source of the attack. Right from the device trajectory, we can start protecting our endpoints by quickly quarantining files associated with this attack. We can even quarantine the vulnerable version of Java to plug the gap completely. These actions quarantine files across the entire organization, so we can ensure that no other endpoint falls victim. Once we've quarantined the files we deem necessary, we can start moving to investigate the attack further, starting with understanding how many other endpoints, if any, have seen the same file and could also be infected. From here, we quickly pivot into file trajectory and start collecting those details. Here we see the specifics of that file and its existence across our enterprise. We have timeframes around the first and last time the file was seen, the entry point for that file, and the parent file that created it. Additionally, we are given the hash details and disposition status, whether or not it's getting blocked in the AMP cloud. Also, a network profile shows us what kinds of domains and URLs the file reaches out to. Finally, we see the trajectory and event history. This shows us everywhere the file has been across our endpoint deployment and any events associated with it. Once we understand all of the details of this file and how it impacted our enterprise, we need to understand what the goal of the attack was. To do this, we can right-click on the suspicious file and jump into File Analysis. This is a human-readable report generated by our built-in sandbox powered by ThreatGrid. This report gives us a list of behavioral indicators that attribute it to certain attacks and malicious intent. It gives us the file's complete network activity and so many other details around how this file interacted with the endpoint. At the end of all of the reports, it provides us a numerical score to help us quickly determine whether it is benign, a score of 0, or truly malicious, a score of 100. There are also a few other features to help keep your endpoints secure by preventing attacks before they begin. Starting with exploit prevention. It's designed to combat the more advanced fileless memory-based attacks. The engine will monitor memory and processes that can be exploited and run them in a decoy random memory space. When an exploit is detected, AMP can log and terminate that decoy process safely without impacting the true process. Low prevalence shows files that globally exist in very small numbers and could potentially be harmful. AMP will automatically analyze these files through ThreatGrid and through retrospection, automatically quarantine those files that returned a malicious disposition. This keeps you protected against some of the stealthiest attacks automatically. Cognitive threat analytics. This affords you agentless detections. We know all endpoints that are vulnerable may not be able to take the installation of endpoint software. To ensure all of your endpoints are protected, we leverage proxy logs from your network and run them through behavioral analytics and machine learning to identify compromised endpoints. With these capabilities, AMP for Endpoints will keep you protected against the latest attacks. And for that 1% of attacks that gets through, give you the most complete visibility and analysis tools to quickly remediate and protect your endpoints. Thank you.